Hey folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome back to a brand newly updated, that's nearly English, Primal Carnage Extinction. This is the Flyer update with big changes to the Pteranodon and the Tupandactylus and a few other pretty cool changes along the way. I'm going to show you a couple of new skins first of all, then we're going to check out another new feature as part of this menu and then we're going to play some games. So, the Pteranodon, let's have a little look at the skins here, let's just swap to a nice regular pattern there. It's pretty cool actually. And if we go into our mutations, you can see we've got a few new ones over here. We've got Inartus, which is I think this combo right here, the original production line of Pteranodon, very cool. We also have Phylongus with this gigantic long swooping beak with that little needle tip at the end. It kind of looks like a proboscis or something like that. It's kind of terrifying. We've also got Dracos, which has this kind of dragon-shaped sort of horn curve thingamajiggy going on. And we've also got, is this the one new as well? Primigenus, I believe, which uses a pleosaur DNA in a Pteranodon, which is kind of mad, actually, when you think about it. And I should have a skin for some of these. Is it that one? Could well be that one. That's pretty awesome looking, actually. Don't know why I want to use now. We're hopefully going to play some Pteranodon today. I think the Glacial one actually works really well with that. And if we hop over to our Tupandactylus, let's pick a brighter skin so we can see what's going on. The Piranha Tupa, amazing. And in our mutations, again, we've got that Primigenus one, which is the Pleosaur DNA. Oh no, it's Mosasaurid, this one, even better. And Anurognathus, and we also have Malus, which is amazing. It doesn't look like that though. Am I crazy? Why is the crest different? Maybe I have to change the skin, is it this one? Yeah, but it's still, I mean, it looks awesome, this Basilisk Tupa. Thankfully, the scientists didn't choose to give venom sacs to yet another species. Now, I don't know if I've got any other mutations, but I thought we'd focus on those ones. There is, however, another brand new feature I want to show you. So we've got our Rex here, we've got our Integrum Rex, we've got our Sleet Rex skin. And you'll notice if you look at the bottom, we've got this brand new colorizer. This is a whole new thing. You can buy a tool, it's like a paint can. And if we click on this, you'll see you get something looking like this. So we select a layer, this one here, for example. And I've been very nicely gifted a few paint buckets. There's some we don't have, as you can see down here, but we've got a few different paint buckets here. Some are rarer, some are more common. There's some, you know, golden ones which are super rare. And what you can do is essentially what's this do? I have no idea. But you can just colorize and kind of design your own skin. This probably isn't the best dinosaur for it. Let me try to find a skin with a few more. There we go. Let's give this one a go. Okay. So paint layer one. You see that red that kind of moves over the top? I think this is Okay, that doesn't seem to be changing it actively right now. Stick some gold on there, stick some... And basically what you can do is combine all these paint layers together. It's kind of like layering it over the top of the dinosaur. And you can create your own brand new skin, basically. Or colorize existing skins and change how they look. It's a really interesting... Oh my god, look at the eyes as well. Yes, please. That's pretty sweet, yeah. So you can, if you wanted, you could kind of custom create your own skin, and it should work for every dinosaur and every skin in the game because it's just over layering over the top of what is already there. Sure. Okay, my crazy looking, I've not played the game in quite a while, so I'm gonna be rubbish for a little bit, but it gives me a good opportunity to talk about some of the other changes. So one of the important ones I haven't mentioned, one of the important ones I haven't mentioned yet is now between, oh my god, what level are you? Between games, as in, you know, if we load into another game now, the teams will get shifted up, they're mixed up, basically. The teams will change now between games. Instead of the same groups of players dominating games over and over and over again, now it changes each time. So it should make things much more fair long term, I would suggest. You know, the teams will keep shifting and shifting and shifting, and you'll end up with different players each time, and it might make it harder to play with the same people over and over again, sure, but in terms of keeping it like a fair game, it should be a really, really good change. So I'm quite excited about that. Also, whilst we're dealing with these tyrants here, the tyrant system has been shuffled up a little bit more as well. Now what happens if you die as a tyrant, you can no longer play a tyrant, essentially. You kind of have to, so if we kill this little lad over here, my big pink glowy gun. If we take down that tyrant, as we just did, sort of, Sorry, focused. Didn't seem to do any damage there. If we take down a tyrant, then another player basically has to load in as a tyrant. You can't pick it again. I don't know what the timer is on that. I don't know how long it takes. I got my party pistol. Don't mess with me. I don't know how long that would take, but the idea is simply to let other players place the tyrant, because usually in the past you'd kind of like have to be waiting desperately for someone to die as the tyrant, and then quickly you'd swap over, or you'd sit there. You've seen me do it. You've seen me sit on the character selector screen and kind of wait and wait and wait and hope for my chance of playing as the tyrant. And now that should be much less of a problem, hopefully, going forward. So that's I think that's a really good change as well. I need the ammo. Who are you? You're my enemy now. Dandelion. I don't know if that's your name. It is, it's Dandelion. I wonder if that's a Witcher reference. That dog outside is going bloody mental. I need health, actually. Yeah, so I'll talk about that. I'm gonna talk about that. Obviously, as I said, this patch is really all about the flyers more than anything else. The Terror and the two Pandactylus have both had fairly massive changes. How are we doing? Well, you know what? We're pretty close. Yeah, I see you up there, buddy boy. And you over there, buddy boy. Everyone's a buddy boy. So there's been two major changes. The two Pandactylus now has a secondary move, finally. It's a dive bomb. I'll hopefully be able to show you that during this video. Whoa. It looks so ridiculous with my big floppy head. give me a minute. And the Pteranodon. So in the past, it's been quite difficult to always know. When you could grab an enemy, right? As a Pteranodon, you kind of like go in, you put your claws out, and you go, and if you just about miss it, you kind of miss it. Now there's like a ready up mode or something. I don't really know how it works. I'm gonna have to try it out for myself. But basically, you can go into a ready up mode, get your claws ready, swing in, and then grab someone. It's meant to make it a lot easier, basically. I feel like it's the kind of thing I need to try out for myself before I can really commentate on how it's gonna work. But it's a good idea. We'll see. I mean, it's a dive bomb on the Tupa that I'm really excited about. And I think that's about it for things. Oh, and the Overraptor. The Overraptor's had a bit of a change as well. Now, the Overraptor Roar, which used to highlight humans and traps and stuff. Now, it highlights humans and traps and all throwable items. But it will actually also show you specifically if there is a weak human. If there's a human on low health, they'll glow like a deeper red or like more red. So, So basically you'll be able to like pinpoint which enemies to go for as the Overraptor, which I think is a really cool little change as well. It's all dinosaur changes, or like flyer changes, so really I need to not be a bloody stupid human. So we'll skip forward a little bit, and we'll check out some dinosaurs. That's right, 15 damage, baby. 15 freaking damage. See, that there was the dive bomb, I think, actually. It's like a little 1.5 second charge down to the ground kind of thing. You'll never take me alive, Spinosaurus. Yes, son. You're in my house now, I guess. Got a party pistol, ready to rock. Pew, pew, pew. I've no ammo for anything, man. Oh, I was actually confusing low ammo for low general ammo. It's not, it just means I need to reload. I was thinking, yeah, I'm running out of ammo really quickly here. Whoa, we're actually winning as humans. Madness. It's the one thing I really want to see in this game happen long term. It's simply balance, you know, that I feel as a human and as a dinosaur that I have about an equal chance of winning the game. Now, with an asymmetrical multiplayer game, that is a very, very difficult thing to do. Don't get me wrong, it really is. But obviously that has to be the target long term, right? Yeah! Don't know how I was alive. No idea how I survived that long. And I think that's it. Yeah, that's everything I wanted to tell you guys about. They've mentioned publicly, you know, that the PS4 update. I know people are waiting desperately and have been for such a long time. I totally understand why people are frustrated. People have been waiting for absolute yonks for a PS4 update, but I promise it is being worked on. It's on the way. I think it's the next big idea, basically, is that PS4 update. So you might not have to wait forever. And there's also some new style changes. One of the maps has changed quite a lot. I think it's the one with the big dome. And there's some new shaders and stuff like that. The dinosaur shaders look a little bit better and stuff like that. And it's quite hard to see in-game. You'd have to have like a proper comparison up, I would suggest. But it's nice that things like that have been updated still. You know, just little changes make the game look pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty. Come here, you. You overgrown turkey, probably. That's what an Ipocamphosaurus is, right? It's just an overgrown turkey. That's okay. Alan Grant would be so disappointed in me. Oh no, we're losing. I'm not playing. I mean, I've got loads of assists. I feel like I'm just not getting the kills. You know what I mean? I've got my big floppy head. Why am I not winning? The big floppy head will guide me to glory, as it always has done in the past. I am the big floppy head. Get you back, Jack. Yeah, told you. Jack's like, thank you, bro. I think that's Sagasol, actually. Sagasol, I've got you back. I mean, I was reloading and then I died, but that's neither here nor there. I wonder if I've got any, bear with me. I wonder if I've got any gifts. Sometimes I have gifts to give out. Let's have a look. Maybe do, maybe don't. Not this time, I don't think. That's a cool spray, though. Got some cool sprays, actually. I don't recognize all these. The Happy Sarah, that's new as well. So wait, so much stuff. Wait, isn't it? Yeah, no, never mind. I just want the server to be distracted so I can murder them all. No, don't auto, wait, no, do auto balance me. I want to win. Please auto balance me. I'm a bad boy, I deserve to be auto balanced. I can't be trusted. Why are we getting gone? Yeah, we're like, I don't want to exit them much. Oh. Sad. You can do this, team. You and me, to the end. Yeah! Okay, there we go. So, Tupandactylus. Terrifying Basilisk Tupandactylus. And the alt fire should be a dive. So you can kind of ram like so. And then is it right click? Boof! And you see it does like a big AoE attack kind of thing. If they put me on the human team now because I got to play dinosaur for 4 seconds, I'm going to be disappointed. That's right, disappointed. I went there. Please don't. Please don't. Pretty please. Pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty. Pretty, pretty. Hey, Tupandactylus. So I want to try the Tupac. I want to try out the Terra. But yeah, so I'll show you again. Meow. It's just like a big AoE clear kind of thing. I want to show you the Tupa of the Terra and the Ovi is the idea. I look awesome. Look at me. I look like a monster. An absolute monster. It's great. I finally look like how I feel. Okay. I just want to dive bomb someone. That's all I want to do in my life. See, the thing is as well, one of the good ways to battle against dinosaurs, generally speaking, as humans, is to group up, right? That's why Carnotaurus is often so good. Ugh. Okay, that was rubbish. Fly! Fly, you fool! That's why Carnotaurus is often really good, stuff like that. I mean, I hit someone. I wouldn't say it was immensely effective, but I did hit someone. We're getting smashed. I'll keep going. Man, I need a different skin. I'm not blending in very well enough. That's the problem. That's the only problem. I don't like that. I wonder why that's got a different shaped head. I'll figure that out. Look terrifying. Let's go. Right, how do I? Yep. See? Totally blending in. Stark white snow and me, the bluest thing in the world. Teeth, man. This thing's monstrous. All those spikes along the back and everything. It's crazy town pants. Crazy town pants. Oh. Meow. Yeah. Oh, got a kill. Amazing. That's all I wanted. You can see how it works. What you need, unfortunately, is you need a bit of communication. You need to dive bomb in as other people go in for the attack, right? The point is to split up, sort of grouped up groups. Which is a bit pointless. No! No! You cheeky blighter. Which is a little bit pointless if there's no follow-up from anyone else. Let's try the new Pteranodon. Da 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 da. Okay, so that's just a regular attack. Nom nom. If I right click, ready up. So is that what it is? I'm confused. I don't really see how that's different at this point in time. I'm sure it is. I'm not sure how. I need a minute to figure it out. Give me a minute. All I need to, I've got an Oviraptor dive bomb kill. Now I need a Pteranodon kill, and then I need to do my Oviraptor. Got my goals. Stop trying to shoot me. It's against the rules. Oh, hello. But it's not for me to kill. Crush, kill, destroy. You can see. Ah! Nope! Well, I was never fantastic at this in the first place, and it's a whole new mechanic, sort of. I don't know if I'm doing it right. Primary attack, peck enemies to death. Secondary attack, yeah, I mean, it seems the same. What was that different? I think just the timing is more generous, I think, is the idea. I think basically in the past you would right click and it didn't really do anything unless you were right by a human, right? And now it's more like you can do it all the time. Or something. I'll figure it out. I'll figure it out. Big brain. Gurk. No one will believe that. Where are the human? Right there. It's because of my mutation. It's not the right one. I need to be. That's what I need. I need a big old beak. Is what I need. That'll solve everything. I need to be bright pink, obviously. Obviously, this is there. We now we're cooking with petroleum. Here we go. Look at me. The hottest pterosaur the world's ever seen. Don't shoot me. That's so rude. Okay, go. Okay. I cannot figure out why it's different. I think it is just that it's like more a general ability you can use at any point. It drains stamina really quickly, so you can't just hold it. But, look at how many people are trying to murder you, and you're here just focused on me. I see you, Shadow Man 9991. Annoyingly, it's a really bad time for the terror. What I should really be doing is playing as the two Pandactylus would actually be perfect for what's going on here. But no. 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 I like how you can mark already marked enemies. 3 points, you know. Trappers. I need to stay away from the trappers. You! You're my goal. What are you? You're not a trapper. I know you see me. I see you too. Don't know how you... Oh, you're trapping me from there, you cheeky little blighter. Who do you think you are? I want to roar again.
How are we doing? Nearly.
There we go. Da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da. Da-da. Da-da. Ah! So close! I think. Ish. Come here! God damn it. Still alive, still alive. Oh, okay, we're okay. We're okay. Yes! Yes! You numpty. I've died. But glory! But glory either way. Okay, cool. Pteranodon done. Thingy done. Two Pandactylus done. Where is my beloved Oviraptor? That's a Cryolophosaurus. Where is the Oviraptor over here? I say beloved. It's looking freaky these days. Which one's this again? The Tropios, yeah. Look at this one! Oh, amazing. Based on the crested grebe. There's definitely some skins I haven't shown you. Alright, I look beautiful. It looks so bad. But in like a really cool way. Let me just quickly check these. Carcharus, that's not new, I don't think. I don't think there's a new there. So I need a list. That's not new. 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 Nit! Nit! Don't yell at the dog. I died. Overraptor time. So, I'm going to show you this final raw thingamajiggy. It's been fun, this. I should play this game more often. Maybe just like every couple of weeks, we'll try it. Oh, I don't look like a dinosaur at all. I just look like a Grebe out for a stroll. And wait a minute, what are these Tyrannosaurus Rexes doing here? Madness. Whoa, Nelly. Whoa, what? Why do people insist on ruining my fun? I've got a weak head, a weak chin. The Grebe can never be a boxer. Does that reference make sense? Maybe it'll make sense to someone. Right, I need enemies. Right, unfortunately, they died within about 2 seconds. Right, I've got armor. Blue, Abadi Abadi, I'm ready. Yeah, what are you gonna do against all this armor, son? Nothing, bam. Super Grebe mode. Super Grebe mode. Didn't work. Man, I just want to show you the bloody rot. See, look, detect nearby enemies through scent. Oh, it's only visible to the other raptor. Hey, what's the? That's a terrible roar. There's a few roars that mark enemies out, but the others mark them from other players. So what's the point in doing it? Super Grebe mode. Super Grebe mode. Yeah, Super Grebe mode. Look at me. I am the Grebe now. I am the Grebe. I am the Grebe. I am the Grebe. I was the Grebe. There's two of them. There's the only reason I died. I need an unmarked enemy for this to work, I think, in theory. I've got 30 seconds. Let's go. The biggest 30 seconds of my life. I just need an enemy. I just need an enemy. I just need an enemy. I've got 20 seconds. There. Yeah, you see they're all grey. There's no red on their outline. That's because they're high health. All of these guys are on like maximum health, basically. And that's why they show up in grey. I showed you! Before the end. Grebe! Grebe. Okay. Well, I need to have a short day today, unfortunately. But that was a lot of fun. I quite like the shorter rounds as well. That was good. Let me have a look at the store, see what cool things lined about. So you can see some of the stuff we got here. Polar Flare 2, but that is a beauty. And that one, the Carnival one, I really... Oh, amazing. And if you wanted to make it funky, you can, let's colour a skin. Let's make a cool skin. Because I don't think I actually did any. I'd like to make sure I didn't do any. So if I go back into my Rex, do I have all those colours? Yeah, I do. Okay, cool. So what we need, I guess... I mean, it makes sense to colour like a Tyrant, right? Because you're going to show it off more. We need a Tyrant... Oh, what a beast. We need a Tyrant that's got like a really cool skin, but maybe isn't in a colour that I love, right? That would be, that would make the most sense. I'm a little anxious. Wait, you can't colour these, can you? Can you? Did that do anything? I feel like it's not doing, wait, maybe it is though. It's hard to tell. What if I pick all the blues? We'll be able to see that easier, in theory. No, I don't think that's doing it. That would make sense. It wouldn't make sense for that to do anything, right? I was surprised when I thought it was. What about this one, though? Let me just... Ah, you cheeky blighter. I don't know, because I'm kind of like committing to killing... Do I not have any duplicate skins? That would help my life. There we go. Let's call it a Scarecrow Rex, because I got about 5,000 of the bloody things. Okay, cool. So, I want to put some red. Let's just stick some colours in here. I mean, that looks awesome. I don't know if any of these colours are like... Oh, they are, though. They're all contributing to making it crazy looking. So the sky blue... Why is the sky blue not doing anything? That's interesting. Where's my gold? That's quite solid as well. Maybe it needs to be paint layer 1. I've made a monster. Let me get rid of these. I need to know how this works exactly. I assumed that they were layered in colours. So if I put paint layer 1 on and then add paint layer 2, it like staggers over the top of it, right? Okay. Right, now I don't want... The question is, what colour do we want? So we don't need this one. Let's just colour in... We can make a red one. Make a terrifying blue one. Purple one's pretty cool. I don't know what this does. It changes it, but it doesn't change it entirely. So that basically just changes... I think... Oh! Right, see, I thought what this was... was like a opacity over the whole thing, right? But it's not. It's controlling how deep a color is being replaced. You can see here that this is replacing all the darker shades, all the black with purple. But if I up this, it starts to replace the lighter shades as well. So if we wanted, in theory, we do like a... Let me pick a better undercolor. Obsidian. Well, obsidian's a bit pointless on this one. But then if you wanted to overlay that. Yeah? See what I mean? It's pretty cool actually, this kind of like blue. You can see how that's got the red all over it kind of thing. And then this kind of brings this in and kind of brings back the orange. And then it brings in the blue like that. I really like that, like half blue, half red, maybe? Is that good? Be more like that? Yeah, that's better. Is that cool? What if I check another one on there? Oh. I don't think so. I might go for this. I just want to make one. I just want to see how it works, you know? Some freaky stuff right there. Okay, let's just go for this. Safe. Oh, I have to select the paint mixer. Okay, so then you use a paint mixer tool, which is another tool that you can get these from leveling up and doing challenges and stuff. So you use that and you save. And I make a colorized Scarecrow Rex. So if we then go back onto our dinosaur, onto our... There it is. Scarecrow Rex. Colorized Scarecrow Rex. And now it's part of my skins. It's a really interesting idea. I think how successful it is will depend on how easy it is to get paint buckets, maybe. Or like how often you get them when leveling up. And how easy the tools are to get as well. And maybe people will find skins that are like really well designed for colorization. I think that'll be a big thing as well. Because obviously it's very skin dependent. But either way, yeah, really cool update. Much smaller game size. Much more efficiently done. Ready for, you know... oh, can I pick like a... What's this? I want a picky. Where do we get a picky? I want a picky. Oh. Much smaller game size. Good pterosaur update. Overraptor roars a little bit better. Team reshuffle is really good. Tyrant lockout, I think, is actually really important. Visually, the game has some new shaders and stuff. Looks a lot nicer as well. And yeah, I think that's about it from me. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very, very soon. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. Check out Primal Carnage Extinction on Steam and on PS4 soon. Not yet, but I will tell you when on PS4. Promise. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye bye. Reaching out.